Dear students, in today's lecture, let us make an attempt to know about rat flea. Firstly, I would like to briefly explain about fleas, and then I will let you know about rat fleas in detail. Let us know about introduction. Fleas are aterous wingless insects, usually with a dark to reddish brown colored body. Fleas measures around 1.5 to 3.3 millimeter long. Fleas have tube-like mouthparts, which are piercing and sucking type, and adapted to feed on the blood of different animal hosts. Fleas have three pairs of long appendages, and the hind pair is well adapted for jumping. By using elongated hind limbs, a flea can jump vertically up to 18 centimeter and horizontally up to 13 centimeter long. Fleas take off from their tibia and tarsi, and not from their trochanter. Interestingly, fleas do not use muscle power, but they use energy stored in a protein called resilin. Hence, fleas are considered as one of the best jumpers of all known animals, including insects, relative to their body size. So, now let us know about habitat. Fleas are nidicolous parasites, live with the host's nest. Moreover, they live in the clothing, beds and couches, make perfect homes for many flea species. Interestingly, fleas only attach to the host while they are sucking blood, and other times they are free living in the host's nest. In general, fleas inhabit tropical and subtropical habitats and rarely occur in temperate conditions. However, it has been shown experimentally that the fleas flourish in dry climatic conditions with a temperature of 20 to 25 degrees centigrade. But certain species, example Gynopsylla cheopis, requires a dry climate, that is a tropical or subtropical climate, for pupation. Further, fleas are live in various terrestrial biomes, namely desert, savanna, grassland, chaparral, forest, scrub forest and mountains also. Moreover, fleas also occur in urban and suburban agricultural ecosystems, where rat species typically found in these habitats and other human related habitats. Fleas also occur in seaports and other rats and rodents inhabited areas. Fleas feed on a wide variety of warm blooded vertebrates such as dogs, cats, humans, chickens, rabbits, squirrels, ferrets and mice. Thus, fleas are prevalent in urban as well as rural ecosystems. Classification of fleas. Fleas belong to the order Siphonoptera, that include four suborders. They are number 1 Ceratopylomorpha, number 2 Istricosylomorpha, number 3 Pulicomorpha, number 4 Physiocylomorpha. First suborder Ceratopylomorpha. This suborder include one superfamily, that is Ceratopyloidea. In this, only one family, that is Ceratopylidae, is present. Suborder Istricosylomorpha include three superfamilies, namely superfamily Istricosyloidea. It includes four families such as Istricosylidae, Tenosylidae, Ampicillidae and Chimerosylidae. The superfamily Macropsyloidea includes only one family, that is Macrocyllidae. Superfamily Stephanocereidae includes only one family, that is Stephanocericidae. Suborder Pulicomorpha includes four families, namely superfamily Pulicoidea. It includes two families, Ectopsylidae and Pulicidae. Superfamily Melacopsyloidea include three families. They are Melacopsylidae, Racopsylidae and Vermipsylidae. Superfamily Cotopsylidea includes only one family, that is Cotopsylidae. Superfamily Ancitropsyloidea includes only one family, that is Ancitropsylidae. Suborder Physiocylomorpha include only one superfamily, that is Physiospiloidea. It includes three families such as Lycopsylidae, Physiopsylidae and Stevelidae. Over 2,500 species and subspecies of fleas exist around the world. Approximately 94% of all fleas species are reported to feed on mammals. These insects act as vectors, carry pathogens by which fleas transmit dreadful diseases such as plague, murine typhus and feline leukemia. Few important and commonly occurring flea species which have been described worldwide are as follows. Number 1, Oriental rat flea, scientifically called Genopsyla cheopis, human flea, Pilex irritans, northern rat flea, Nosopsyllus fasciatus, cat flea, Tenops cephalolidis felis, dog flea, Tenocephalates canis, moorhen flea, Docillus gallinale. Dear students, let us know briefly about human flea, Pilex irritans, cat flea, dog flea and moorhen flea in brief. However, the details about Oriental rat flea and northern rat flea will be discussed a little later. So, first human flea, that is Pilex irritans. It is a cosmopolitan flea species and has a wide host spectrum. It is one of 6 species in the genus Pilex and other 5 are all confined to the Nearctic and Neotropical regions. Cat flea. It is one of the most abundant and widespread species of fleas on this planet Earth. It is a small sucking insect, measures about 1 to 2 millimeter long. Its body color usually with reddish brown and sometimes the color may vary. It has laterally compressed body and quite hard to find on its host body. Its primary host is domestic rat, but it also infests dogs at different parts of the world. The cat flea can maintain its life cycle on other mammals also. Now, the dog flea. It is again an important ectoparasite of both wild and domestic canids around the world. It is similar in appearance to the ubiquitous cat flea, but it is encountered less frequently and thus it has not been studied thoroughly. However, it has been reported on many mammalian hosts including dogs, cats, rabbits, rats, grey foxes, red foxes, woodchucks and humans also. It can act as an intermediate host for parasitic worms including the double-pored tapeworm and the nematode. Now, the moorhen flea. It is a large flea originally from South America. It is now a globally widespread flea species. It is found in bird's nest and on the bird's body. It is commonly called the chicken flea. It is normally found in the nest. Its other hosts include the common moorhen, Eurasian woodcock, grouse, European robin, gold crest, willow tit and Eurasian tree creeper. Male and female fleas can be distinguished by their genitalia structures. Male has 2 heavy horns like spines on one of the genital flaps, while the female has deep bite on the 7th sternite. Dear students, now it is time to know about rat fleas in detail. Rat flea is an aterous insect, live in human inhabited places, preferably at the vicinity or inside beds and bedding areas. The rat flea was collected in Egypt by Rothschild, JNC and Carl Jordan in 1903. He named it Cheopas after the Cheopas pyramids. In general, rat fleas, scientifically called Genopsyla cheopis, usually inhabit tropical and subtropical habitats and rarely occur in temperate conditions. Experimentally, it has been shown that the rat fleas flourish in dry climatic conditions with a temperature of 20 to 25 degrees centigrade. But Genopsyla cheopis requires a tropical or subtropical climate for pupation. Rat flea is a parasite of rodents. There are 2 species known commonly around the world. They are number 1, Oriental rat flea. It is scientifically called Genopsyla cheopis. The second one is northern rat flea, that is Nosopsyllus fasciatus. Firstly, let us know briefly about northern rat flea, that is Nosopsyllus fasciatus. It is a minor vector and a parasite of domestic rats and house mice also. It is an external parasite living by sucking the blood of rodents. It is the most widely spread of its genus, having originated in Europe but has been transported to temperate regions all over the world. N. fasciatus has an elongated body, measures around 3 to 4 millimeter in length. It has a pronotal tenidium with 18 to 20 spines on the first thoracic target, but lacks a genital tenidium. Now, the systematic position of a rat flea is as follows. Rat flea belongs to phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Siphonoptera, suborder Heteroptera, family Pulicidae, Genopsila, species Chiopis. It is commonly called as Oriental rat flea. It is a parasite of rodents, primarily of the genus Rattus. It is a primary vector for bubonic plague and murine typhus. It occurs when the flea has fed an infected rodent and then bites a human. It is also known as the tropical rat flea, the primary vector for bubonic plague. Let us know about the distribution of Genopsila chiopis. It is distributed worldwide in association with its primary hosts, Rattus species. The morphology of Genopsila chiopis. It is a wingless insect with laterally compressed body. It measures about 1.5 to 4 millimeter in length. The body color varies from light brown to dark brown in order to camouflage themselves in their host's fur. The genital and pronotal tenidium are absent. However, male and females are sexually dimorphic. Males have complex genitalia that are easily distinguishable from the females, whereas females have dark colored spermatheca that resembles small sacs, and this becomes a distinguishing characteristic feature of this species. So now let us know about the life cycle of Genopsila chiopis. There are four stages identified in the life cycle of a rat flea, namely egg stage, larval stage, pupal stage, imago stage. First, the egg stage. The rat flea life cycle begins with egg laying. Female lays eggs in batches, and each batch contains around 20 eggs on the host body. Female can lay 5000 or more number of eggs during her lifespan. The eggs are easily rolled onto the ground, and where the host rests and sleeps become one of the primary habitats for eggs development. Eggs are very tiny with white colored surfaces. Usually, after 10 days, egg hatch into larva. However, if the environmental conditions are not favorable, the eggs will take longer period to hatch, and it may go up to 2 weeks to hatch. Now, the larva. The larva, newly hatched larva, looks very similar to a worm. They are blind and avoid sunlight and prefers to stay in dark places like cracks, crevices, and inside bedding. The larva is about 2 millimeters in size. It has a small body and mouth parts. Interestingly, newly hatched larva does not feed on host blood, but it feeds on any available organic material such as dead insects, fecus, vegetable matter, dead skin cells, flea droppings, and other smaller parasites lying around them in the dust. Later, larva starts feeding on blood. Matured larva makes a silken cocoon around itself and pupates. Pupa. Larva will pupate and weave silken cocoons with 1 to 2 weeks after 3 larval stages. The flea remains a pupa from 1 week to 6 months so as to complete the process of metamorphosis. Matured flea emerges from the cocoon. Fully developed flea may remain resting during this period until they receive a signal that a host is near. If any sound vibrations, heat, and carbon dioxide available nearby pupa act as stimuli indicating the probable presence of a host. Imago. When the flea emerges, it begins the final cycle by entering into imago stage. Once the flea reaches adulthood, its primary goal is to find blood and then to reproduce. Therefore, blood feeding is must for an adult flea to enable reproduction. Adult flea starts sucking the blood from its host body with the help of piercing and sucking type of mouthparts. Matured male and female fleas mate. A single female flea can mate once and lay 50 eggs per day. Adult flea would live up to a year and can stay in the cocoon stage for up to a year if the conditions are not favorable. Adult flea populations are evenly distributed in the host nest with about 50% eggs, 35% larvae, 10% pupa and 5% adults. The favorable conditions include congenial temperature, humidity and food supply. Optimum temperature and humidity for the flea's life cycle respectively are 21 degree to 30 degree centigrade temperature and 70% relative humidity. However, if a flea is unable to get host for food, it can leave only for a few days. If ample food supply is available, the adult flea will live for longer duration. Now let us know about the transmission of the pathogen. It occurs when bacteria enter the flea's gut and multiply rapidly. Soon the flea's proventriculus is blocked by a mass of bacteria and it cannot fill its stomach, causing the flea to search for a new host. After biting the host, the blood of an uninfected host mixes with the bacteria in the flea's stomach. Then the flea expels infected blood back into the wound, consequently infecting a new host. Gynopsyllon cheops goes from host to host, infecting the uninfected. Hosts may also become infected either from consuming fecal matter or dead remnants of an infected rat flea. Transmission of plague disease. The plague disease causing pathogen is bacterium. Flea could transmit plague among humans by transmitting the bacteria as follows. First, by flea bite. The infected rat flea bite result in primary bubonic plague or septicemic plague. Plague bacteria are most often transmitted by the bite of an infected flea. During plague epizootics, many rodents die. Hungry fleas seek other source of blood. People and animals that visit place where rodents have recently died from plague are at risk of being infected from the flea bites. Dogs and cats may also bring plague infected fleas into the home. Second, by plague pathogen. The plague causing bacteria is Yersinia pestis. The pathogen maintains its existence in a cycle involving rodents and their fleas. In places with dense rat infestations, the plague bacteria can cycle between rats and their fleas. By plague infected person, man becomes infected when handling tissue or body fluids of a plague infected animal. When infected animal are handled without taking proper precautions, the pathogen will transfer to healthy person and become infected with plague bacteria. This form of exposure most commonly results in bubonic plague or septicemic plague. Now, transmission of plague through infectious droplets. When a person has plague pneumonia, his cough droplets contain millions of plague bacteria which will get into air. If these bacteria containing droplets are breathed in by another person, bacteria can cause pneumonic plague. Typically, this requires direct and close contact with the infected person with pneumonic plague. In this way, transmission of plague would occur through infectious droplets and spread between people. Moreover, cats are susceptible to plague and getting plague infection by eating infected rodents. Sick cats pose a risk of transmitting infectious plague droplets to their owners or to veterinarians. Let us know about the symptoms of flea bite. Fleas are a pest species to their hosts. They can spread rapidly and move between areas to include eyebrows, eyelashes and pubic regions. Fleas bite site as a single puncture point in the center and develop itching sensation that result in discomfort and leads to scratching at the vicinity of biting area. It also develop a swell at the biting area. Bites often appear in clusters or small rows and can remain inflamed for up to several weeks. Itching causes air loss, especially in wild and domestic animals. Anemia is also possible in extreme cases of high volume infestations. Adult fleas bite pests and humans, causing pain, redness and itching at the bite site. Now, the flea allergy dermatitis. Pet animals which are severely allergic to flea saliva can become so itchy as a result of flea bites that they literally tear their skin and fur apart with their scratching and chewing activities. Sometimes coat of the pet animal will damaged, so due to scratching and over grooming activities, it leads to damage of skin and fur, and that would encourage flea parasitic infestation. Skin diseases. Flea infested skin that is traumatized by flea bites and by animal scratching and biting activities can become secondarily infected with nasty, itchy skin bacteria. Anemia. Heavy flea infestations can suck so much blood from their animal host that the host can weaken and even die from severe blood loss. It leads to the development of anemia. Infectious disease transmission. Gynopsila cheopis is a parasite of many mammalian species, including rattus and humans. Because of its parasitic nature, it acts as a vector for pathogens such as plague bacilli, Yersinia pestis and murine typhus, Rickettsia typei. Gynopsila cheopis carries the tapeworm of rats and mice and serve as an intermediate host for mouse tapeworm. Now, let us know about the plague. It is a disease that affects human and other mammals. It is caused by the bacterium Yersinia pestis. The human flea is capable of being a carrier of the plague bacterium. Plague is infamous for killing millions of people in Europe during the Middle Ages. Without prompt treatment, the disease can cause serious illness or death. Today, human plague infections continue to occur in the Western United States, but significantly more cases occur in parts of Africa and Asia. There are three forms of plague that can be transmitted to humans by fleas. One is bubonic plague. Second one is septicemic plague and third one is pneumonic plague. Let us know briefly about bubonic plague. It causes patients to develop sudden onset of fever, headache, chills, weakness, one or more swollen, tender and painful lymph nodes. This form usually results from the bite of an infected rat flea. The bacteria multiply in the lymph nodes closest to where the bacteria entered the human body. If the patient is not treated with the appropriate antibiotics, the bacteria spread to other parts of the body. Now, let us know about septicemic plague. It occurs as the first symptom of plague and develops from untreated bubonic plague. It affects patients to develop a fever, chills, extreme weakness, abdominal pain, shock, bleeding into the skin and other organs. Skin and other tissues turn black and dye, especially on fingers, toes and the nose. Now, brief information about pneumonic plague. It results in patients developing fever, headache, weakness and a rapidly developing pneumonia with shortness of breath, chest pain, cough and sometimes bloody or watery mucus. Pneumonic plague develops from inhaling infectious droplets or develops from untreated bubonic or septicemic plague. After the bacteria spread to the lungs, the pneumonia may cause respiratory failure and shock. Pneumonic plague is the most serious form of the disease and is the only form of plague that can be spread from person to person by infectious droplets. Now let us know about the treatment of plague. Plague is one of the very serious illness that can be treated with commonly available antibiotics. Very sick pneumonic plague patients should be placed under critical observation. Preventive antibiotic therapy would be given to the plague infected persons. Depending on the type and time of personal contact between sick and plague infested persons. Since more than 3/4 of a flea's life is spent outside the host animal, it is not adequate to treat only the host, but it is also important to treat the host's environment. Further, through vacuuming, washing linens in hot water and treating all hosts in the intermediate environment on a regular basis. Let us know about control and treatment of rat fleas. Use anti-itch cream such as antihistamines or hydrocortisone or calamine lotion to get rid of itching due to rat fleas bite. Use flea repellent powder against rat fleas. Follow integrated pest management practices at the host level. Integrated pest management is achieved by adulticide to kill adult fleas and insect development inhibitor like lufenuron or insect growth regulator like metoprin to prevent development of immature stages. Lufenuron is a veterinary preparation commonly called program that attacks adults, larvae or eggs. It avoids larval ability to produce chitin, which is necessary for the development of hard exoskeleton in adults. Cedar oil is a non-toxic natural substance effective in the eradication of infestations in pets. The environment should be treated with a fogger or spray insecticide containing an insect growth regulator such as pyriproxifen or metoforini to kill eggs and pupae, which are quite resistant against insecticides. Frequent vacuuming is also helpful. The vacuum must be used around everything the animal frequents to pick up all the larvae and eggs. Disposing of the bag after each vacuuming will kill 96% of adult fleas and 100% of younger fleas. Bathing can dramatically reduce the rat flea population on a badly infested animal, especially when in combination with a mild detergent or shampoo and brushing or combing. Baking soda can be used to kill rat fleas via dehydration. Table salt can also be used inside the home in the same way as or in combination with baking soda as a low cost and safe method of breaking the flea's life cycle. Pulverizing or grinding the salt with a coffee grinder will make it more effective as it will stick to the flea, killing it quicker through dehydration. Borax, a natural laundry booster, can be used as a treat rat flea infestations. Borax contains sodium borate, which kills fleas by dehydrating them. Rat fleas cannot withstand high temperatures, so a turn through the dryer on medium or high will kill the fleas. Soap can also facilitate the death of rat fleas in bathing. So now let us conclude about rat fleas. A rat flea is an aeterous insect, live as parasite on rat species and its host's nest. It is distributed at different parts of the world. It feed exclusively on the blood of rodents, including man. It is a nudicular parasite, live at places preferably inside beds and bedding areas occupied by rodents and other mammals. Its infestations can be noticed by observing the symptoms appeared on the host animals. Rat flea bite develops prominent itching sensation and various allergic reactions. Although rat flea spends only a lifetime on its host body, life cycle will be completed within the host's nest. Its bite develops several adverse health effects such as allergic symptoms, skin rashes, and develops secondary infections also. Rat flea can be detected by their characteristic body shape and appearance. Rat flea population can be controlled effectively by following mechanical, chemical control and also by an integrated approach at its host's environment. Thank you.